Nerd On.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the weekly show where I share some of the most interesting news in gaming. This week we'll start off by celebrating the release of Detroit Become Human, we'll go over the latest news in Sea of Thieves, release date news for the upcoming No Man's Sky update, and finally we'll take a closer look at the new Battle Royale mode coming to Call of Duty Black Ops 4 called Blackout, and we'll explore what this all really means. This is Game Byte. First up, we have the release of the long-anticipated Detroit Become Human, launching today on PS4. This is the latest effort by studio Quantic Dream, responsible for 2010's massive hit Heavy Rain, and the lesser-received Beyond Two Souls. Detroit Become Human is set in a future where you take the role of three androids and explore the different facets of how the androids have been integrated into society. I've personally been very much looking forward to this. The sci-fi spin to the usual Quantic Dream formula is exactly what I've been waiting for to get me more invested in this type of storytelling. If you're interested in learning more or seeing what the game is like, be sure to stop on by to our Twitch page on Friday while I'll be streaming the game live. Links down below. Next up, let's talk about a major update coming to Sea of Thieves in just a week. Titled The Hungering Deep, this will actually serve as the first of a series of six planned DLCs for the game. The first update will be more modest from a content standpoint, but should still serve to keep things fresh until a more major update that is slated for the summer. The Hungering Deep will include weekly events with new mechanics and new items to collect, but will focus on a new AI threat that will take multiple crews to defeat, so you're gonna have to coordinate. The Hungering Deep update will arrive May 29th and will of course be delivered free, as will the rest of the DLCs as well. In other release date news, we have a confirmation for the release date of the next major update to No Man's Sky, which will be releasing alongside its Xbox debut. The update, simply titled Next, sets to introduce real multiplayer for the first time in the game, a feature many believe to and expected to see at launch. The release date is set for July 25th on Xbox, and strangely, no official release dates for the PS4 or PC updates, except the detail that they will arrive shortly thereafter. Hopefully it's not any longer than a couple of weeks. Anyways, it stands to see if the addition of multiplayer alongside all of the other major features they've added over the past couple years will be enough to bring players back into the game. Is that enough for you? Let me know down below. I think it definitely sounds interesting, but we need a lot more details. I own it digitally, so I'm kinda stuck with owning it, so if Hello Games manages to dazzle us during E3, I might just have to jump back in. But anyways, next up, let's move on to the story of the week. Now, in customary pre-E3 fashion, companies are starting to drop their big pre-show reveals and demos. I mean, we got a pretty sweet demo for Kingdom Hearts just a few days ago, and that game looks absolutely incredible. Hopefully I can get my hands on it during E3, I cannot wait for this game. But anyways, the news is actually in reference to Activision with their upcoming Call of Duty Black Ops 4. Rumors had been starting to circulate that this installment would be marking the first time that Call of Duty would be foregoing its story campaign, and instead developing a Battle Royale mode for this latest installment, as other Battle Royale modes like Fortnite seem to be at the peak of popularity right now. Well, in a snazzy reveal trailer from Activision, it turns out those rumors are in fact true. Black Ops 4 will feature a Battle Royale mode titled Blackout, and the trailer claims that they will deliver a BR mode no one else but Call of Duty can. It will feature trademark Call of Duty fast-paced action, epic scale, places and equipment from across the entire Black Ops games franchise, and will also feature ground, sea, and air vehicles. When developers Treyarch were asked about why there would be no story campaign, they essentially responded with some figures about how their multiplayer culture has evolved over the years. Studio co-head Dan Bunkting had the following to say, "When I first started on multiplayer in the Call of Duty franchise, 10% of our population was playing competitive multiplayer. Fast forward to 2015 or 2016, you're looking at 90% of our players are playing multiplayer. If you look at it through that lens and trying to deliver more for your players and how you're playing the game, it's a pretty easy decision." So, you know, his remarks make sense. I mean, Call of Duty has never really been known that well for its story campaign. Yeah, they've definitely had their moments, but they're probably not the most replayable parts of that game. Of course, the online multiplayer, things like zombie mode, those have been the staples for Call of Duty over the past few years, so it totally makes sense to lean into that and bolster their multiplayer experiences. I, for one, am actually pretty interested in this Call of Duty game. The last Call of Duty I played was Modern Warfare 2, but I have to say a Battle Royale mode with the fast-paced action of a Call of Duty game does sound pretty compelling. I'm also very happy that more companies are experimenting with and helping to grow this genre of gaming. Battle Royale games are very easy to pick up and fun for the casual player, but will often feature a high skill gap that keeps core players interested. BRs bring us all together. Aw. Details for Blackout are still slim, but I'm sure we'll learn more about it during E3. Anyways, that's all the news I have for you this week. Are you excited for Detroit or Sea of Thieves? What do you think about BRs coming to Call of Duty? And is the next multiplayer update enough to bring you back into the world of No Man's Sky? Let's discuss. Drop a like if you enjoyed this video and subscribe for weekly gaming news right here on Nerd On. Thanks for watching, happy gaming, and I will see you all next time.